some of the concepts, as I told you, never taught in the class, many things. But they will make big difference. So therefore, even though you already took, you already know a little bit about gas kinetic theory, I mean, just open your brain. So I will tell you something missing in the ordinary textbook. And then the second lecture is heart of what I'm doing. And it's mathematically very difficult. But nonetheless, any of you wanted to learn those momentum methods, you have to overcome this mathematics. Once done that, then all other lectures you can follow this. And remember, this is highly mathematical. And you will need some efforts. Even though I started this subject 20 years ago, my understanding, as I told you, but remember, non-equilibrium means you have to take care of all those small parts. And in general, non-equilibrium distribution looks like something like that. So you have average, you have variations, it's not symmetry. That's not same as if you look at polynomial. Polynomial, it can be whatever variety. Remember this. Therefore, if you just naively expand distributions in F using Taylor expansions, you are in deep trouble. Taylor expansion will not guarantee your expansion, in particular second, third, higher order terms, will make you this F always living above the water. So, then why this fact wasn't emphasized in textbook? Because we are living in year equilibrium. So only these matters will become issues when you talk about N delta is high enough, which means you need to keep not only first term, but second term, third term, fourth term. And then you will see that problem. So in many cases, once you use Taylor expansions, your argument is just because I will never cross this deep water because I limit myself into the second order or something like that. The problem is that's a beautiful argument. But nonetheless, you apply that formulation into real problem. You never know. They will safely say you always live above the water. Sometimes because problem demanded locally. I'm not talking about airplane here, that's complete computation domain. We don't know. At particular point, you are in deep problem. Then your theory will just miserably fail. Because fluid dynamics, all other theory, must make sure physically correct every point. This is very important. F must be positive. So, then question is, we agree F must be positive, including all other methods, LBM, all others, you must be careful about that. So I will present the other alternative to overcome such very critical problems. I mean, you need to understand that concept, but it began with that simple findings, because F must be negative. So they require another mathematics. We call cumulative motions. I will explain later. That's heart of all three lectures and the next lectures. So why need that expansion new mathematics? Because of that. You cannot use anymore Taylor expansion. If you like to use Taylor expansion, you have to keep all the terms, because non-equilibrium means things here, because this is average. Therefore, you are likely finding molecules in this region. But very rare case, you will find this one. So difficult of non-equilibrium means many other engineering mathematics, you just keep first order, second order, then you are okay. But non-equilibrium flow now, you have to like in Tapam, this we call tail and all Protestants. Very rare event. That rare event, if you use tail extension, make you negative, this will function. Then all your formulation just collapse. You cannot claim, you cannot publish your journal papers. Of course, reviews does not, this one you will publish it, but in the fundamental level, your theory is not firm grounded. Okay, so much for motivations. But you just, you took mathematics, you will see this one. So the important one is, the F is probability. To find, in this case, specific weight, the car, the number of cars with the weight. I mean, you have BMW and trucks in this couple of towns. Then you can have this kind of the analysis. So this is FW means, the important one is the weight. That's why you use W, the weight control. So why I choose this weight rather than velocity and so on, because this kind of the analysis method belongs to not only gas dynamics, but also all other complex systems, including not natural things. Let's say the money, the stock markets. And then that money is, you cannot see that money. In this case, weight. It's not gas molecular velocity. So this is how why many mathematicians, they apply Boltzmann's equation to the subsocial system and to the stock market and so on. The point is, once you can do that, good mathematicians like the freedom. They think, they want to think freely without any limitation, but that is dangerous. And then it's okay to apply this kind of thing to the stock market and so on. But if you apply this kind of things to the gas motion, this motion is things in nature. The nature has governing laws, like thermodynamic laws. So you cannot develop just mathematically. In the end, you need something else in form of physical laws. That's things I like to emphasize. Otherwise, you just are familiar with this mean average. So you have the probability. And then you put some quantity and integrate from weight cannot be minus from the zero, but velocity can be minus. In that case, from the minus infinity to infinity. And then this we call average or moment. Therefore, method of moment rely on this kind of mathematics. So I don't think that this will be very difficult to understand it. And then looks familiar, right? And the gas dynamics. And then this is the distribution function in location r and the v with the velocity. And then this is a total numbers, the distribution function for total system. Then if you divide that quantity by the density. Density is defined by this one, then this becomes normalized, which means total sum of the distribution function is 1. Probability cannot be higher than 100, so cannot be minus 20. So that reflect on the not capital of this F. So again, so this is look like gas dynamics because I use the V instead of W. But remember, they are all conceptually the same thing. Probability theory. But once you use the weight, there's pump gas dynamics. So please, I think that in every engineering, you must be aware of the importance of symbols. You better use simple symbols so that your brain can immediately identify what that means. So studying mathematics separate from physics sometimes is not good because you have to understand, you have to make your brain understand the mathematics, and then you have to understand physics separately. Then it not coming together, you limit yourself. So this is anyway examples, but symbols. Please remember symbols, and the way and so on. So again, dvx, I already told you, because minus infinity was infinity. And you cannot define one dimension. But that says, cannot move molecular level only one direction. Okay, then you know that every gas dynamic textbook, or before that, it says we know that equilibrium disturbs function, the Maxwell, later on, function. And then, what is it? The important one is its exponential functions. This is my favorite to tell my students importance of numbers. Nothing else. It's not cosine sine. It's not scalar test. It's E. Remember, E is always positive. Another point is, forget all other things. The beta is unknown here. Later, you'll see that it's related to temperature. But from the Boltzmann equation, whatever, actually, beta cannot be determined by the kinetic equation alone. Why? Because as I told you, probability theory is not only gas, but also like weight or stock market money. The money is not governed by thermodynamics. Therefore, in principle, you have some theory which can be applicable to not only gas, but also weight and the stock market. That beta must be free parameter. Otherwise, you cannot apply something developed from gas dynamics to the stock market. That's why beta is unknown here. And then later on, we will see that beta is one of Kevitz-Boltzmann fundamental constant. M is mass. It is given numbers. Important one is. So here's temperature control. I think that among conserved variables, pressure temperature is the most important one. Even though we think temperature, you understand the temperature, no, it's like some time. But it's difficult to understand what temperature is. So, therefore, this is equal means the assignment. Beta is something adjustable parameter, free parameter. Only when you assign this quantity to beta, they become this kind of theory. If you assign something different, not temperature, maybe money, then this become equilibrium solution in the stock market kinetic equations. Because in stock market, there's many, many people. They're more like the gas molecules. Millions, billions of people somehow behave as gas molecules with respect to money. So you can develop some kind of kinetic equations for that stock market or animal kingdoms. So that case, you could have different. Gas dynamics, we know that is T, and that this V minus U is everything. Therefore, this is the random velocity. So in the gas dynamics theory later on, this is anyway, we call local equilibrium. Because why we local, this T can be function of position. It's V and time. That's what we call local. Otherwise global. But T is everywhere something. So in this room, because things are moving, now in this position with that particular temperature will be not the same as here. Then even though but that point come by this particular. And there's temperature, and then you have the molecular velocity and everything. That's it. That's what we call local Maxwell Boltzmann distribution function. Okay, so a little bit. This is another some interesting problem. So let's say. World-wise poll among mathematicians. What do you think is the most beautiful mathematical equations? So let's say there are in the world many famous mathematicians, and then one reporter asked her, what do you think, because mathematician means they know many, many mathematical formulas.
Very famous one will appear high school, middle high mathematical textbook, right? So you already know that. Some quadratic formula and so on. And then what do you think? This point. Anyone have an opinion?
Fermat theorem.
Oh, Fermat theorem. Okay, that's a difficult one. Yeah. Oh, no. What else?
e raised to i pi plus 1 equal to 0.
Oh, something like that. And what else? This is whole. I mean, you cannot have a definite one. But the answer is, you will see all, I mean, this, I learned this, I think high school, something like that. Then you will see what this is. This we call Euler formula. By the way, I think this is true. The number one, the mathematical formula was this Euler formula. You all know that. I mean, but that is answer. Why you think mathematicians chose this is the most beautiful one?
Gives them more short way to represent the bigger equations.
Yeah, probably that's part of the senses. But to me, this E appears. So that is connected to these questions. What do you call among every human being? What do you think is the most beautiful numbers? That's my answer. but I think actually we polling that one. I think the it should be, yeah. Someone said the pi, the candidate would be B, what else?
Zero.
Yeah, this is India. Little bit prejudiced. And then what else? I call pi. Do you know what pi is? For the section that better Google it. And if you have the mobile phone, Google it. It's a golden section. Golden section. It explains beautifully the nature. Like the, something like the, this kind of shape. The animal. Each pattern, it recalls what is a fractal. Have you heard about fractals? Anyway, very important concept. And then I think the art, imagining numbers. There is good history. How human beings overcome the hesitation to accept the art because it's imagining numbers, which is scale. How in the world you can scale root to negative? So then you can think of why this is the most important one. Because not only E, but also I appear in just one equation. And if you put theta is pi, then therefore, in fact, this Euler formula contains all of important numbers ever human being invented. But not only that, I mean, you think of more about Euler formula, it's beautiful. Okay, anyway, what that has something to do with here, because you are talking about equivalent distribution functions. It means something.
So what was the answer from this? E?
Yeah, I think that should be E. 2.7, something like that. So again, back to that E is always positive. By the way, do you remember what E looked like? Function look like? Very important one. You learn high school. Ex means this one. Ex means this one.
Look trivial.
we'll see this is essential in the complex system. Why we have E? There's reasons, because Maxwell, Boltzmann, this is the function is the form of expansion. Now why this matter, what particular this minus, by the way, do you know that this is Ex in minus, then probably you will remember this funny functions. Do you know what this is? Yeah, hyperbole?
Sine function.
Sine H. This is the most important function in method of momentum. I will demonstrate it. Because, why? Because this is fundamentals of this kind of the shape. And then this one is the opposite. Therefore, in Boltzmann collision integral, remember what Boltzmann integral means. See, I just use it C2, and then there's a star something minus there's no star something. The star something represents, let's say, this one. Minus without star something represents this one. So this is essence of the Boltzmann collision theorem. I think I'm the first person to realize that aspect. Look at the Boltzmann collision integral in this way. Anyway, that keep it in mind. This exponential function somehow appear here, wherever you do in the kinetic theory. The reason is simple, because equilibrium distribution function is exponential function. So, okay, that's a memo you have. And then for next coming lectures, I will show you why it's Gaussian. Now because of that, why in the world Gauss kinetic theory can be applied to viscoelasticity? Because whatever, either binary collision, or there is a macroscopic, very complex molecules, in the solvent, like water, and then, why you can apply these things? So what happens is interaction is somehow just like a control volume. Remember the fluid dynamics in the under the sea. I have the net. I take into account number of the fishes cross in, cross out. The same thing here. It should not be necessarily binary collision, but the other interactions can be explained this way. In the simplest form. Of course, in order to do that, you have to do something mathematics and between, but nonetheless, conceptually, that's possible. It's, as I said, bold proposition. Okay, then let's go to the little case. I mean, this is easy to understand once you accept it, but very difficult to persuade somebody else. Unless you have subsequent mathematics. So that's what I'm going to do. The Boltzmann equation, just read it, some assumptions. Physically very important. So mathematically, maybe not. The real equation is, our job is how to solve equations. The important one is molecular chaos and black hole, which means, do you remember Liouville equations? Doesn't have this kind of Boltzmann equation integral. That case, just like the MD, it's time reverse is possible. I mean, you have a collision and then some future, but you can reverse. But due to this critical Boltzmann collision integral, you cannot do that in the case of Boltzmann. It's called breaks of time reverse. That's the why this can describe this reversal process. Because that fan is rotating, then probably room temperature will go high. That's one direction. But if you lower the room temperature, that doesn't mean that you rotate Gallery. That's the one example, impossible of the reversal process, age, when you embark this question. So that kind of is effect on this one, and also this star something minus, this is nonlinear. Even though it's F star minus F, it's not linear. Anyway, therefore these things you need to know, that's the source of the molecular chaos and break of calculus. So without these terms, everything is calculus. You can go back to yesterday and the past. Of course, in nature it's not possible. That's something. Another one is, again, this is time derivative. Just for the moment, remove this one. In many cases, just steady state. That one rotating steady state. Then, even though it's non-equivalent, this rule, for a field, you can describe without this terms. Then you have what is the V is motion of the velocity of molecular. And that with scalar product and the gradient, which is the slope basically in the space. Remember, this contains x, y, and z. Therefore, this becomes partial classifications. And because f is dependent variable, appear only f. Therefore, this is linear equation. You have f star or log f, something like that, that becomes linear. It's very, very difficult. Therefore, LBM, what are the methods? Somehow, just look at that simple point. Oh, this is linear equation. And they build on that fact. But I warn you, that's only part of story. But you have linear right-handed terms. And also, because you have two terms, let's say the question is, this is the original Boltzmann equation. I mean, if you solve these equations in reverse way, no problem. But you cannot do that. Otherwise, we don't need to study this subject. It done deal. Boltzmann presented equations, he presented his solution. Why we bother study this? And then there is no reverse solution for the Boltzmann equation, which means we have to approximately solve this equation. Then remember, there are two terms. And always better, because two terms means they are interacting each other. Therefore, you approximate something here, and you didn't approximate here, it's unbalanced. Unbalance means like a seesaw. So let's say you approximate these terms, it's tenth order accuracy. And but you approximate these terms, it's second order accuracy. That's unbalanced. Oh, why you bother unbalanced? Well, dependent problems, it doesn't matter, but dependent problems, it does matter. So therefore, I mean, as I told you yesterday, I mean, you have the 5 second tent. I mean, you see it? 5 seconds later, you have beautiful tent. You can play with it. But after vacation, you have to go to home. Time is running. And it takes 1 hour to wrap up that tent, that problem. So you need to consider both. Don't limit yourself one particular form of limitations. The many cases, but that doesn't matter many cases. But the shock wave, in the case of the viscoelastic fluid, it's opposite, extension, we call it elongation. You have a polymer, and the stretch, circuitly. Nature never fails, but you have a computational models to solve viscoelastic flows. In such case, most of the models, they break down. Then many people don't know why. The same way, the shock wave. Gases colliding each other with a so high velocity, then you form shock structures. In that kind of problem, as I told you, unbalanced treatment will make problems. So anyway, I can say many things just looking at this Boltzmann case. And the distal movement, I call it kinematic. This is collision, but displacement is thermodynamic terms. The energy from the kinetic energy to become thermal energy like that. And so that replace the irreversible. So collision indicates binary each collision, but viscoelastic fluid, it just interactions. The macromolecules is moving within the liquid. And then you apply some gradient. The liquid will move. And the motion of liquid will interact with macromolecules. That kind of effect can be described by this function. Not necessarily for time interpretation, but you can invent it. So they will become molecular theory of viscoelastic fluid. Otherwise, you have to try it empirically. There's many models, Maxwell's, Aldrich, and so on, but in many cases, they're lacking molecular kinetic theory. Okay, so again, a little bit about those Boltzmann collisions. So, I didn't, wherever possible, I don't write down Boltzmann equation. I don't memorize it, because I don't need to do so. Textbook is there. Why you care about memorizing Boltzmann collision integral? Important one is, what is it? As I already told you, it's gain and loss. But this is phase space, defined 7 dimensions. One is time, but for the moment, forget time. Then you have a 3-dimensional space. And then you have another 3 velocity space. You can imagine 6-dimensional space. But difficult to visualize, but you can think of it. And then consider two particles. They will interact for specific the time. And then what is the outcome? In the Boltzmann's viewpoint, this is brave. You can find this drive in Vienna. Once you visit Vienna, you can do that. I mean, I was busy, but I was too busy in the going to other famous site. But anyway, this is I took from the website. Yeah, this one, because his work on the entropy. It's connection from the micro and to the macro in form of this one. Yeah. Again, there's a log. Log is your coin, there's a head, and a tail. Head is exponential function, tail is dollars. It's the same thing. Because you know the element of the mathematics, something like that. Ln E or E ln, it just simplify, right? They are same thing, the tail and anyway. And then to me, but this is something very important contributions. But to me, the beauty of the Boltzmann's equation is this concept. Just like control volume, remember the control volume. It's exactly the same thing. This the volume integral some rho dV plus some surface integral and the rho u in the case of the yes equal to zero. So this part is conservation laws. So you have imaginary control volume. First term represents the change in time of some quantity must be balanced by net flux. And the gas molecules comes in or going up. Exactly same thing, slightly from what? Because why we have scattered? Because they are collides. Important one is into means in. Out means the same thing. So you can see the parallel in the this macroscopic fluid dynamics. You know that this is a sense of the this is physical laws valid in the irrespective of the degree of non-equilibrium, either equilibrium, non-equilibrium, rarefied, micro, nano, whatever. This is valid. Therefore, this form is more like gain and loss. that's it. Detailed form of this is not important. Important one is you can divide these collision terms into two terms, gain minus loss. Then let's say gain is ES, loss E minus S. That's become hyperbolic saturation in approximation sense. Okay, you can find these symbols in many textbooks. And there are many test dynamic theories, including Vincent and Gombos' book, they explain this way. But that's this is start. This is scaling, let's say, after. And this is read before. Don't be confused by you have this is FF binary. Because of that, you have F and F2. So before that, this star minus something makes this term is nonlinear. Therefore, go back to the previous equation. The original Boltzmann equation is nonlinear equation. There are many methods. Because it's nonlinear, very difficult to simplify this equation into the linear term, which is relaxation approximation. Then everything becomes nonlinear. Then they solve it. But by doing so, you introduce a very critical assumption. This term was linearized. Whether or not there is a serious approximation or not, it depends on the problems. But you must be aware. Otherwise, you can expect, because that kind of assumption is already introduced, if you increase the Nusselt number or degree of non-equilibrium, you can expect your method will fail because of that assumptions. So the key question is always this kind of difficult subject is check every assumption you introduce and then make sure that that assumption will not make any trouble. Or at least you should know I introduced such interrupt. Therefore, in the end, my theory will have some kind of limitations. There's nothing wrong in the introducing approximation. We always do. Okay, so there was the guess kind of theory. Decency maybe. By the way, before Professor Rakesh will explain this afternoon about this and so on, so on. But I just show you in this aspect, verification and validation of JSMC. Because JSMC is a pure simulation method. It doesn't have any analytical solution like Blasius solution and so on. So you don't have anything to compare. Of course you can compare with the experiment. But the experiment has own limitations and so many cases, as I told you, agreement with the experiment doesn't mean sometimes you are producing the right solutions. Sometimes it's coincidence just. Then, if you wanted to verify, which means, let's say there is most accurate solution of this and Z, then I want to compare my solution with that imaginable solutions. The problem is no such things. Then I look at then what errors inherently the present in the JSMC. This is one way to clarify. One is decomposition error. Just like the fine size of the set size of safety. I mean if you use the instance fluent, always supervisor will tell you how many grid you use. Many will give you just indicate the small the decomposition error. So time step. And the cell size, this is more typical one. But the PD based method, this is typically only decomposition errors. But in the case of JSMC, because you introduce representative particles, there's the room for how many. Many will be better, but in general, I guess. But the small will be sometimes introduced, sometimes errors. So we have the other factors. And then, because JSMC is Monte Carlo, which means F some calculations, we have the positive sense to produce some average quantity, like a temperature. Then what you have to do is you have to run Monte Carlo many times. And then you have to make a sample of it. So number of samples, the number of particles. So that something to do with we call statistical errors. Many will be better, the question is how many. Depending on the problem, I worked beautifully this morning for hypersonic re-entry vehicle, but I applied that method to something else. Cavity flow, microscale flow, something like that. Then, how you determine this kind of thing? Very, very challenging issues. Of course, you run first time and check whether or not your solution, those average quantity doesn't change. Then, oh, that's where I can start. But you already solved it. So therefore, what that means, you have to do twice. You don't have this kind of some guidelines. So one for how many I have the samples. And then with that information, you run again, then you have answers. So they will increase harm. So that's the issue of this. And then machinery is not important. And then again, the otherwise beautiful theory, always you have problem when you confronting with this solid one. Either PDE, the sensing is rational, that's a fine thing. I will show why. No. Anyway, because we have to do this boundary condition, so verification idea is simple. Because remember, including SMC, MD, LBM, whatever method, if you wanted to honor conservation laws, your final solution samples average quantity must satisfy this one. In the case of the steady state, this one. In and out, there is a very famous hamburger restaurant in the United States. You know? Anyway, in and out. So this one. This one. This one. Oh, this is sometimes when I submit these papers to the journals and the reviews. They are otherwise very influenced by famous reviews, even though they are anonymous. I can say that. But they travel in accepting this simple point. Because they always thought this is Navier Stokes' case. It is not. Navier Stokes only have to apply these first time gradient U, then become Navier Stokes, which is not be applied for times. But there's no limitation of this conservation law. So anyway, and then the challenge is the learning. By the way, as I told you, there's mathematicians very seriously studying approximation in order to prove well positives. And he won the Pulitzer Medal, the highest honor one can get. You are under the 40, something like that. He won the field medalist. And he wrote beautiful some textbook of Boltzmann, the kind of equations from the mathematical viewpoint. And I found this statement. And therefore, I use it very often. It is not my statement. Let me repeat it. The conservation law, for example, this one, should hold true when there are no boundary. In presence of boundary, however, conservation law may be violated. Momentum is not preserved by specular reflection. These are very familiar terms and the distance and so on. But that's where error comes in. Which means you can invent some new boundary condition strictly satisfy the conditions. That comes from the next subject, if you like to do so. Anyway, this is why there's errors associated with solid world boundary condition. Every solid world boundary condition derived from different purposes. Never thought about strictly satisfied conservation law problem, at least in macroscopic sense. But the PD, if you solve Navier Stokes, because this is summation of four interfaces, the case of a triangle, they are balanced. Therefore, even though Navier Stokes is not accurate in Navier's non-equilibrium, but it satisfies always conservation laws, which means shock location is always true, even though the inner structure of shock waves may be wrong. So that's the why sometimes Navier Stokes perform very well, because it built upon conservation law. Now once your method is built upon conservation law, you cannot fail completely. So to me, let's say 80% of all those fluid fields is just captured by conservation law, probably 20% of constituent. Okay. So then I apply, because in general, this can be used to general, including 2D and 3D, but very difficult to integrate. So I simplify the problem. This case, 1D. 1D means just in and out, you can check it. So this is shock structures. Again, even though why I'm using so often shock structure, because that's my favorite topics, but shock structure is the ultimate test of non-equilibrium theory. Believe me, you have beautiful theory about non-equilibrium. You cannot solve shock structure this problem. I don't think that's the theory. You have limitations. Anyway, the shock, which means this is the upstream, this is downstream. The Euler framework, this discontinuity, Rankine-Fugazi relationship. And the gas particle suddenly increase temperature, pressure, slow down. And then this region is very huge. The narrow in order of the micro is probably less than 10 micro. Very, very thin. But you zoom, then you can see this kind of nature never be discontinuous unless contact is continuous on. But even atomic, subatomic level, that discontinuity may be continuous. The same thing here. And then this is conservation law. Remember, I used the shear stress, not Navier-Stokes. This is not gradient of U. So this must be strictly satisfied if you want to satisfy conservation law. And then, which means these kind of things must be remain constant. Then you can check that whether or not in the computational domain this quantity remain constant. Otherwise, that's error. So this is that. This is downstream. The shock is like this. This or this downstream. This is the upstream. I use number two, because we are dealing with shock structures. Therefore, the scale is imperfect. Therefore, this number one means this number one. But this size is, let's say, 5 micron. With that narrow the regions, this kind of thing, the eye check, percentage of the normalized error is not absolute error, it's normalized error. So that number is important. So this is 1, this is 0.1, something like that. You can see, I check X momentum and other mass conservation or energy. You can see in the case of X momentum, this is where shock structure is from. You can see there is some, but that was expected. The same thing you find from ZP. Because it's so steep, numerical error is pretty bad. So once you have this kind of the error, then you can come up with some method to reduce these errors. But that's the power of verification.
EOS?
Equation of state. TSMC, you are using explicitly, therefore the error must be it's machine level. That's the reason. But all others is not machine level. There is errors. But the X momentum error is big space. I use very fine computation time. Delta is very small. It's normally far smaller than the recommendations. Which is one deal if I can do then. Also, delta is very small and it's this big and this big. This is very fine calculations. If you reduce this one, this error will become So by doing so, you can see that some computational errors.
And then again, we checked those time steps. So time step small is better. This one is error the B. Oh yeah, this is the case. Delta is big, as you can see. In general, this kind of the, why we have the biggest error here, because it is where the slope probably the highest in here. So if you increase the delta, and then they will give you the bigger, and then time step interval, that this is not accurate, this is accurate. Then you can check percentage of errors. In the case of the x momentum, you can see, check that this is more like the accuracy with respect to time step. So as I told you, once you increase bring the cell number twice, accuracy increase the same rate that the first one. Similarly, you can check order of accuracy in the case of TSMC by plotting this. This slope represents order of accuracy. Because of that, you can invent, if you want to do so, some method to increase order of accuracy. You are not satisfied with first order accuracy. So in that case, once you time step interval size decrease steep, then you increase accuracy of TSMC. I don't know if that's possible, but if you have this kind of method, you can check that. In this case, cell size is more like a CFD. You have the million grid, the 400 million, 6 million grid point. You can check this. You can see this slope for different conservation laws. One is mass, one is momentum. Because only one, we have the one-dimensional flow of energy. So this slope will represent order of accuracy. This is the dose cell size. In this case, with respect to the number of the particles per cell. As you can see, even though you increase a lot, there is some exaggerations. So that means don't use this much. Somewhere here, that's the reactor you start. Because anyway, you want some efficiency. So that kind of the useful can obtain from this kind of analysis. And then this one, the beauty of the one-dimensional shock structure problem is free-formed solid one. Very few fluid dynamics problem has analytical solution without boundary conditions. So that's another way to emphasize the importance of shock structures. But this case worked. I checked it. This is quarter flow. You have the lower plate. Either way, one is moving or both moving. Very famous one. And then again, you can check conservation errors. Then there's a factor, because something, because it's world driven. Why the non-zero fluid motion is generated? Because world is moving. Therefore, error will be high near the world. So in this case, this is a world. This is another world, it should be symmetric, but the TSMC is something like randoming. Therefore, not strictly symmetric, but in general, symmetry. So you can see, this is, I think, what is it? Again, Y momentum or X momentum, there is some percentage, let's say 1% or 5%, so on. You can find some errors associated with the world boundary condition. As Villani says, the specular deflections, conservation is not strictly satisfied. Therefore, the errors. Of course, that error will affect in general Dirac coefficient or not, I don't know. Someone needed to check. And then, because of that, the conservation law is more like the exact solution of pure simulation. You can apply this method to NV, I guess, if you have those postal processes. So this is error defined by norm. It's, you have the quantity and the square, and then square root. So everything becomes positive.
the second norm, very typical error, and then use the space to the sampling numbers. Then, as you can see, after increased enough sampling numbers, then the error decreases. Yes. So this is this slope will give you how fast JSON-Z converges to the accurate solution. After some position, then it's more like saturation. The same thing you can find from the other safety method. Why many cases? Because due to the boundary conditions. Many cases, boundary condition will fault those convergence. But anyway, this is first time to check the errors for all the errors, not only decomposition errors, but also statistical errors, and now world boundary errors. So, because conservation law doesn't distinguish it. So this is somehow maybe useful. Again, this is more increasing the numbers, and then again you can find the pattern. This kind of slope. I mean, in JSON-Z, there's a theory, the analysis predicting this slope exactly matches the deadline, and then flattening off. So you don't have to use this kind of very fine numbers because you already flattened off. No more gain. Okay, this is the verification of JSON-Z. So, I mean, just I want to share that. Simple ideas on the fluid dynamics and the conservation laws, sometimes very useful. And then I think you can apply the same method to molecular dynamics, so that even though, I mean, everyone, people believe in me, but nonetheless, if you yourself actually run some code, and sometimes you wonder, am I right? And you know, if you want to obtain some confidence in your results, you can do this one. That's important, because this is about very painfully building confidence one time. And then you build that kind of confidence this year, next year, for different problems. Then that becomes your asset. So you not easily give up, even though somebody say your result is wrong, or your general paper is rejected, because you already have this kind of confidence, then you can overcome. It's all about willingness. In particular, you are talking about difficult research topics. I cannot teach you that kind of thing, but I want to share with you. Okay, any questions?
So, if you go back, maybe where you are showing the different errors, like previous. How have you computed P, the threshold from DSMC?
Yeah, there.
This P from DSMC.
Yeah.
The last one, equation of state.
Also the P. Oh.
Yeah.
I think that I discussed with the Karchani and the DSMC. I think this is that explicitly implement into the DSMC code. Therefore, I think that this P is not coming from those post processing. Oh no. I think that these relations somehow, depending on your code, explicitly implemented the code. In this case, probably that's the case. But you can have different way. I mean, this P coming from those statistical post processing sampling, and then also separately row and P, and then you can check that they will be slightly different from explicit implementation, but this case I think explicit implementation.
Okay. I'll talk to you more about it. And one more point regarding the Villani's statement, the previous one, you were referring to the Villani's, So here I have a point. Actually, in the presence of boundaries, conservation laws will not be preserved, right? Because part of the momentum anyway has to go to the wall. So why should the conservation laws
work?
Oh.
In the fugue domain, I mean.
Yeah.
That's a good question.
Let's say in the case of the CFV, this is wall, then you generate this cell and this cell.
Yeah.
And then the question is, I'm talking about this cell.
Yes.
Oh, this cell is also the same thing, but then CFV in general, we explicitly impose those conjugation laws. That's why we did this cell. We designed that way, which means in the reality, the quantity would be something like change this one, but this one cell represents the nearest cell. So it's your options. If you don't want to impose that eagerness to the nearest cell, we can do that. But I think it's better impose that strictness of the conservation law, even the nearest one.
But my point is just the other way around.
The way around?
Yeah, I mean, like if you see the momentum, momentum from the fluid domain can go to the ball.
Oh no, I'm talking about this as a fluid.
Yeah.
This is the solid.
Yeah.
So what I'm saying is, because this, even though this is just one cell,
true,
it is just cells.
Yes.
So within this cells, conservation law must be preserved. That's one argument I prefer.
Yeah.
But you can relax.
Yeah.
But the question is, what that means is you can relax the conservation law here. Then you have to have your own argument.
Yeah.
Why you relax that? The question is, which one will give you in general? Like I said, drag coefficient. Drag coefficient is a sloth. Therefore, this quantity, the average values, will be determined by what kind of logic you put into this cell.
True.
So therefore, these values, let's say the density or pressure, there is a lot of options. Not even you strictly satisfy the conservation law here.
Yeah.
I remember the book, the DSMC, how you define the sampling and so on will give you slightly different options. So my point is, always it's better have some physics is imposed.
Sure. I understand.
And then at the same time, that give you the prediction is better agreeing with experimental data will be best. But it is still possible, you can relax that the strictness in here.
Yeah.
And
if you can go to 19th slide, next, I mean 5 slides ahead, 19th, 16. So what I'm trying to say is that at the ends, close to the wall, maybe we are observing something which is physical, not the error. Like 19th, the previous one. Yeah.
Oh.
Next. Yeah.
Yeah.
Here at the ends, what I'm trying to say is that maybe we are capturing something which is physical.
No.
It's not error.
No, no.
Okay.
It is error. Because it's just one cell.
Mm-hmm.
This one cell is something.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, let's say pressure must be constant.
Mm-hmm.
And this particular cell is just a little bit. It's not that big one, maybe 3% or 5%, but there is some, I call errors, because I define that way.
Sure.
Yeah,
that's
it. Sure.
The similar
signature
is seen at minus 1
also, it's the range is
minus 1.
Oh, this is the bottom, this is upper one.
Similar signatures are seen at
minus
1. Yeah, it is looks symmetric, it should be. So, therefore, I don't know, it is a simple problem.
Yeah.
Then, once you have this kind of analysis, you can design, make sure that error is small. And then my point is, whether or not that kind of things will help the essential predictions in comparison with some theory or that point.
That's very interesting.
Yeah.
Very energetic.
Okay,
so can you go to slide number 17?
17. This is 19. Oh.
So in first figure, There are two black
tubes
actually, cell size, percentage of
cell. Yeah, yeah, this is somehow, this momentum-wise, slowly, and some jump.
But I don't know this one.
What is the physical explanation?
No, I don't know. This is very complicated. Depending on sometimes sampling or whatever.
It shows this kind of thing.
But important one is always decrease.
Yes.
That's the point.
But the second one, if you watch closely around 7 or 8 to the 80, 60 or 80, the blue one.
Yeah, blue is the mass conservation.
Reducing and then it is increasing
little bit. That's possible because this is always Monte Carlo and so on.
It is statistical.
But by the way, please remember TSMC, that's very important issue.
Yes.
I mean, because the other papers I learned about the error associated with statistics. There's two types of errors. One is because you stop earlier, before reaching steady state. And that will bring you the errors. Another way also will bring you errors. So you have to control both.
But the first one is the serious one.
You're right. Anyway. Run TSMC effectively requires a lot of some knowledge and also deep insight, I guess. Probably Professor Rakesh will explain such.
This afternoon I'm going
to. Such one.